अ गिफ्ट ऑफ बोथ लाफ्टर अँड टीयर्स. चार्ली चॅपलिनच्या स्मृतिप्रित्यर्थ खास काढण्यात आलेलं टपाल तिकीट 16 एप्रिल 1978 रविवारी पुलंच्या हस्ते प्रसारित करण्यात आलं. त्यावेळी पुण्याच्या फिल्म इन्स्टिट्यूट फिल्म अँड टेलिव्हिजन इन्स्टिट्यूटमध्ये त्यांनी केलेलं हे भाषण. फ्रेंड्स, आय रिअली डोंट नो हाऊ टू डिस्क्राईब दिस ओकेजन. इट इज बोथ अ हॅपी अँड अ सॅड वन. सॅड because a tribute is being paid in honor of Charlie Chaplin at a time when he is no more with us in this world. On the other hand, there is a feeling of satisfaction that the people of India are expressing their gratefulness towards a clown who was a real citizen of the world. We have heard of a philosopher king like the King Janaka in the ancient times, but in Charlie Chaplin we met a philosopher clown. He was unbelievably successful in concealing a great store of wisdom and an intense feeling for the suffering humanity under the mask of clown. To millions of his viewers, he was the eternal tramp in search of food, shelter, and love. An underdog, he made us all laugh, but this was not a laughter which gives man a sense of superiority over the one at whom he laughs. He made us realize through his clowning what man has made of man. He touched the innermost depth of our souls. That's what all great art does to us. It gives a fresh experience, a fresh start, as it were, in life. It sharpens our sensitivity anew at different times of our existence and in different ways too. Charlie Chaplin achieved all this through his films. To an average viewer, he was a clown. To those who could get a deeper view of his art and philosophy, he was a humanist. And to those who could reach still closer to the message he so very subtly gave through his films, he was a prophet. This reminds me of an incident from his life. On hearing that Gandhiji was to be jailed for an anti-imperialistic activities, Charlie Chaplin told Lord Bracken, "If you do imprison on, Gandhi, another will rise." He is a symbol of what Indian people want, and until they get that they want, they will produce one Gandhi after another. Wasn't that prophetic? The clown rose to the occasion when the world started shaking with fear at the ominous rise of Hitler. The Second World War was on. The dictator started tearing down and destroying beautiful in life to pieces. The humanist and the democrat in Chaplin would not allow him to rest. And at a time in the human history when the best of the man flower was being ruthlessly crushed and when fear was the order of the day, Chaplin launched his famous epic on celluloid, The Great Dictator. Most of us who are in their late 50s and 60s now, we are living through those horrible experiences either directly or indirectly. The peace-loving humanity had lost all of its hope on a decent human society living peacefully in the future. It was at this historical moment that Chaplin came out with his assault of humor against the tyrant who had half of Europe under the merciless control. I consider his last speech in The Great Dictator as immortal as Lincoln's famous Gettysburg Address or as great as Mahatma Gandhi's speech at Gwalior Tank in Mumbai on 7th August 1942. Or refer to the recent times as great as Jayaprakash Narayan's speech on the occasion of peaceful march in Delhi. I cannot help quoting a few lines from Chaplin's speech on this occasion. He says, "The way of life can be free and beautiful, but we have lost the way. Greed has poisoned men's souls, has barricaded the world with hate, and has goose-stepped us into misery and bloodshed. Machinery that gives us abundance has left us in want. Our knowledge has made us cynical, our cleverness hard and unkind. We think too much and feel too little. More than machinery, we need humanity. More than cleverness, we need kindness and gentleness. Without these qualities, life will be violent and all will be lost. To those who can hear me, I say, do not despair. The hate of men will pass and dictators die, and the power they took from the people will return to the people." And here Chaplin sounds a note of warning. He says, "By the promise of the very same thing, brutes have risen to the power, but the lie, they do not fulfill that promise. They never will. Dictators free themselves but enslave the others. In the world of films, we refer to actors and actresses as film stars. But Chaplin, who was an actor par excellence, director, scriptwriter, music director, was a star in all the senses of the term. Like a star, he guided the world which had lost its way and showed the blundering wayfarers the proper direction. He also twinkled like a little star and amused us. And the best of all, here was a rare star who gave to this the world of performing arts could give. Thanks to technology, Charlie Chaplin is still with us to guide us, to make us laugh and make us conscious of the human sufferings. I had the good fortune of seeing him in person when he had reached his 80. It was in Venice. His famous film City Light was being shown in the huge St. Mark's Square in the open-air theater. The later City Lights by Charlie Chaplin were projected on the huge screen. Suddenly, everything went dark and a beam of floodlight was directed towards a balcony of a palatial building, and there he was. Charlie Chaplin sitting with his wife and children, there was a tumultuous applause from the crowd of over 10,000 people gathered in the square. It was a multinational crowd. Chaplin was himself seeing the film he had made when he was perhaps in his 20s or 30s, and the third or the fourth generations of his viewers were responding decades ago. I was not very far from the balcony where he was standing and bowing before the crowd. I saw him, yet I could not see him enough because my sight was blurred by the tears that started gathering in my eyes. Call that sentimental if you like, but that was how it was. Had he lived to see his birthday today, he would have been entering his 90th year. He lived for almost a century and now eternally lives as the man of century. How sad none ever thought of giving Chaplin a Nobel Prize for his great artistic creations, for his contribution to the cause of international peace and goodwill amongst the people of the world, for the joy he brought to millions of people, old and young, belonging to 100 different countries, races and religions. He has already become a symbol of all these qualities during his lifetime, and there were local chaplains imitating him all over the world. That is how the mediocre artists pay their tributes to a genius amongst them. It is true that he got the highest awards, much higher than that of a Nobel Prize, is put together when the grandpas and the grandsons, the poor and the rich, the blacks and the whites all laugh together watching this great clown on the screen. But it is also true that nobody takes a clown seriously until he dies. And then we, for once, start to search within and try to find out the causes of the loss that we feel. How many of us ever realize that humor is the shortest cut to the truth? How many of us know that humor and humanity have always go hand in hand? I'm grateful to the organizers of this function for giving me the honor of releasing this postal stamp issued in the memory of this great clown. They did me this honor perhaps because they thought that laughter is my business too. With all due respect to those responsible for inviting me here, let me call you, my friends, that I consider myself no better than a speck of dust in comparison to this great, great mountain of the artist. If not anything, a little sense of humor in you teaches you to measure your own self very correctly. It is also a significant fact that the stamp is being released in a campus where that younger generation of filmmakers is learning to master the art of filmmaking. I'm sure that with Chaplin's humor and humanism stamped on their hearts, they too will be inspired to create films which will bring out both the comic and the tragic in human life in artistic way. With these words, my friends, I pay my sincerest tributes to the ever-inspiring memory of a man who gave the world the precious gift of both laughter and tears and released the postal stamp issued in his honor. Thank you.